Hi, judges. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Daryl. Along with me, I have Brian. Together, we represent Intrex.
So the show is about want-to-be entrepreneurs that come and pitch their ideas. And there are four judges on the show. And I'm one of the guest judges representing NUS to participate in judging the show.
I mean, and look at this event. Like, we were sold out 3 weeks before the event. And people were just queuing up and saying, hey, we want to come. We want to, you know, join this startup weekend. We want to create a company.
To me, Startup Weekend isn't really necessarily about starting a business immediately right after this weekend is over. It's more about education. It's more about networking. And networking by doing, not networking by talking, right? So when you sit down and you work with somebody for an extended period of time, you have a better idea as to whether you can work with them going forward.
Just a little bit of what are some of the data that are available, including a couple of the surveys that I personally have been involved in doing. As you can see here, the item that was rated, the biggest problem is that of finding appropriate investor who may be interested in their type of startup activities.
I started out in Silicon Valley after graduate school, and I set up a software product company at that time. And it was good timing, and we actually were able to exit very fast at the height of the dot-com craze. Well, as you would expect, I teach entrepreneurship and intrapreneurship.
So in 2003, I started an events company. So during that time, what I did was to buy a second-hand sound system and start to rent it out. That was how I started my first business. When my first business folded, I decided to join NUS Business School. Going to NUS Business School certainly helps me in building up my business foundation. I mean, the knowledge in business foundation. And it's especially helpful in this startup that I'm working right now.
I think there's a potential there. We can look at the National University of Singapore Executive Education Program. There's an advanced management course, and then do some coaching, and then maybe bring him back on and see how he's progressing.
I'm an adjunct professor with the business school. I teach MBA courses. As part of a good MBA curriculum, we make sure that our students have the opportunity to do case preparations, case analysis, and presentations. In the real world, people who are trying to, you know, bat for seed money to start their business, and they just have this fixed time slot to come up to give their best pitch, to present their ideas, and to show the judges their presentation and their preparation. A lot of that is very similar to what our MBAs do.
They said, we, in the social business, we created demilitarized zone. And that's very important. There's a boundary conditions within which you work. But the moment you remove these boundary conditions, you are totally in open world. Your mind can work in a very different way.
My mom is 75 this year. Imagine after graduation, right, you do a startup and you don't bring home any income, or you are not able to pay your bills. That's the greatest challenge.
Entrepreneurship is innovation, and innovation is slightly different from invention. Invention is the thing. Innovation is commercialization of the thing.
As an entrepreneur, you must recognize where your weaknesses are and therefore find people who can help, you know, complement you, and in particular, try to bring in mentors and advisors who can actually give you some help.
And from the passion, you could sense whether the person will be happily waking up every morning and wanting to do what he or she has committed to do. So that's essential, that's important. And the other is how to translate that passion into success. And that's where the business education is able to come in and help.